Bellator 254, live on CBS Sports Network from the Mohegan Sun Arena. We started the night at 185 with Romero Cotton and Justin Sumter.
Well, Romero Cotton started this night off with a lot of force, a lot of grit, and just a mean, mean attitude. He grabs a hold of Justin Sumter, takes him down, gets position, and just forces the choke. Take a look at him, just all of a sudden, boom, no hooks, but grabs a hold of that neck and squeezes the point. Justin Sumter says, I can take no more. A beautiful submission victory, rear naked choke by Romero Cotton.
He remains unbeaten with all of his wins inside the Bellator cage. Next up, a heavyweight collision, Lint Bissell and Ronnie Marks.
This is Lint Bissell's third fight at heavyweight. He came off a big win against Karatanov, but going against a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt, someone that he respected on the ground, you could tell there was a little hesitancy on Lint Bissell. Can I hang on the ground with him? Oh, yes, he could. He dominated Ronnie Marks on the ground, gets to the point where he gets mount. Ronnie Marks cannot stop anything Lint Bissell does. He opens up with big shots, big elbows, hammer fist, enough to the referee says, that's it, no more. A beautiful TKO victory for Linton, the Swarm Bissell.
Two straight at heavyweight for the Brit. Next up, our co-main event of the evening, two brilliant bantamweights.
Boy, we have an incredible bantamweight division now in Bellator, and these guys are adding to it. Look at that takedown. That man is 2 inches shorter based upon that one. We have Magomedov here just being Velcro. He is all over Mateus Matos, who is an outstanding fighter. He just could not stop the takedowns. Seven takedowns overall by Magomedov to get a unanimous decision victory in his Bellator debut.
Then in our main event of the evening, the Flyweight World Championship was on the line. Ilima-Lei Macfarlane and that Brazilian, Juliana Velasquez.
Juliana Velasquez coming into this 10-0, Ilima-Lei Macfarlane 11-0. The question was, could the champion, who knew she had a deficit in the stand-up area, get inside and get Juliana to the ground? She worked hard at it, but it was taking time and energy away from her. She finally gets the takedown in the fight, but it's Juliana that actually ends up in the top position, and she rides that out for the round. Finally, when Ilima-Lei gets her to the ground and opens up, she's able to do good work in the fourth round. Take a look at the head position of Juliana here. That kind of head positioning and control was the difference in the fight. Beautiful jump knee right at the end of the round. Look at this switch knee. Boom, right into the face of Ilima-Lei Macfarlane. But she holds up well, takes it like the champion she is, and comes back on Juliana. This takedown right here, this was a big moment for her. She had lost the rounds before. She gets this takedown, but she was never able to get Juliana Velasquez's back completely to the ground. Juliana takes shots. There was a lot of little shots landed, but nothing that hurt Juliana. It gets her into the fifth round. And with that takedown right there at the end of the fifth round, Juliana Velasquez takes a unanimous decision victory and becomes the second flyweight Bellator women's champion.
For the latest Bellator news and information, go to Bellator.com.